For a few eyeballs to pop up. First, I'm gonna go ahead and primer my skin here. It's time to find more. Squeeze as much as I can out of here. Hello, Mama! Right. Primer on. Have you used your primer yet? Your primer and your lip exfoliator and your Epic. We are going to do a simple two color eye look tonight. I like simple. We'll be using palette 4, numeral 4. All right, awesome. Palette 4. And we're going to use Splurge. The reason I'm using Splurge is Splurge, you can get any color that you would like as part of our kudos. So you get our new anniversary palette, which I wish I had, but I don't have it. You get, which is a $55 value with all the glitter and awesomeness that goes with it. You get to pick which Splurge you want. The reason that you get to pick a Splurge of any color is because Splurge will actually heighten the color of your eye makeup, and I have found that it makes it last longer as well. You also get the cream eyeshadow brush that's with it. You should get it. It is your birthday today. Get it for your birthday. The cream eyeshadow brush, which goes with the Splurge. I would show you what that looks like, but little hands have misplaced that. And you get to pick what color of lipstick you want as well. So you get the, it's a $150 value for $85. That's awesome, awesome, awesome. All right, so let's go ahead. We're going to get started with the eyes. So this is Extravagant. Splurge. I've had this since February. Still got a pretty good amount in there. And it is copper and gold. And I'm going to put a lot on my eye. You're going to notice that. A lot on my eye. Boop, 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 boop. Sorry, I'm a little late getting on. I did a Norwex party. And for hosting, I got like a sample rag, which is pretty cool, and it's this big, and I love it to death. It's the cleaning one, but I need a bigger one. So I was going over there, and now I can't figure out which color I want. You know, the color shouldn't really matter. They all clean the same, but I don't know what color I want. But I need a bigger one. I need the bigger one. So I am putting Extravagant all over my eye, like completely from top to bottom here. The other eye. Make sure everything matches. If you haven't noticed, I am doing a bulk order event. And so this is what I'm doing. I can only offer specials on in events or private groups. So if you would like to be part of, I can tell you I'm offering free shipping for my bulk orders, but I'm also doing a special discount. Oh, me too. A special discount. Yes, it's my mom's birthday. Happy birthday to you. And a special discount as well. And also special on doTERRA essential oil products. So, if you would like to be part of that event, just let me know. Also, if you do not see the red live up here with the eyeball with a number next to it, it means we are no longer live. Please do hashtag replay so I can give you some love for watching. Also, share this video. Sharing is caring. Sharing helps me grow my little business. Y'all help me grow. So thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you much, as my daughter would say. Now I'm going to go over here and I'm going to do a prude, which is this kind of a chocolate. A light chocolate brown, and I'm going to put that all over my lid. I'm going to put it on pretty dark, so I'm going to cake that on all over my lid. I know you care. You are a very caring person. It's pretty awesome how caring you are. Take that on the lid. Right now, it does not matter if you're messy. The reason that we do our eye makeup first is so if there's any fallout, we can clean it up without messing up our face makeup. We've got that pretty well caked on there. We're gonna take this our new blending brush, which is this very fuzzy brush. I need to get another one because I do multiple things with this brush, and I'll show you. This is how it's easy. So I just put extravagant on my eyes, all over, and then on the lid, I just kind of just take on Arrogant from palette number 4, this light chocolate color. You're going to take this blending brush. You're going to hold it at the end. The end will give you more of a softer blend, and then for more structured blend, when you want to get up in here, you get closer. Let me show you that. So down at the bottom will give you more fluid motion. Up the top will not. You're limited motion. So you really want to blend well. So full motion there. If you are on, say hi. Don't be shy. Say hi. I see there's four people, three people on. Changed. They didn't want to say hi. So they're at the end, so we can do more soft blending. So I'm going to do like some circle movements, soft blend, soft blending, blend, blend, blend. Hello, Miss Margie. Using palette number 4. Right now we are blending. Like I said, if you hold your brush at the end, you'll get more of a soft blend. And then also with that dark color with this blending brush, you can kind of go down underneath the eyes here and kind of blend it. And here. And then if you wanted to really get in and do some more packed blending, get closer. Closer, closer, closer. So there is that. So it's like a golden brown look. With that extravagant on the back there, behind there, one, it will stay longer, and then it'll give us more of a brown gold look. And those kind of those gold little shimmers will shine through that brown. Awesome. I'm gonna clean that brush because I'm gonna use it in a momento. I'm gonna work on my face, then I'll come back and finish my eyebrows and my eyes. We're gonna work on concealer now. If you did not know before I got on live, I already had did my primer, Touch Glorious Primer. You want to let your primer sit for about 5 minutes. What primer does? The same thing as think about a wall, put paint on. Think about if you just painted that wall. That paint is not going to last as long. It's not going to look as good, and it's not going to be as vibrant. So, primer, face primer, works the same way. It also goes in and it fills in those uneven spots on your face. If you have big pores or scars or anything like that, it will go in and fill those in for you. And then that way you have a smooth canvas. All right. I'm gonna take, and I am just going to put, I gotta reorder some stuff. A little pea size in my hand. Just a little bit. A little bit goes a long way. I've also had this guy. I've been squeezing this guy since March. March, y'all. I've been squeezing it, just making it work. All right, I'm going to take my finger. I know, I really told you not to use your finger before. That's okay. I am not going to go up into my eye. I learned a trick. If you go up into your eye, then you're going to get clumps and it'll go into your eye. I don't know if you've ever done that. Got concealer in your eye. So just go right below your puffy eye right there. If you have puffy eye, I'm sorry, I do. And then you're going to come down and you're going to make a triangle. I'm going to go up here, winged up here, wing up here, down your nose here, and then make a triangle. Kind of like not a tr like a happy face and then a triangle down at the bottom. If that makes sense. Do the other side. But don't go all the way up to your eye line, just right below. And then down. And then make a triangle. Go up here. And then make a triangle down there. I really want to go look at my first lives and tell you what tips I gave you because I'm sure they are not as good as they are Down my nose. I get really red right here, right here, and then right here. And I also have this pesky breakout right there. I have found since I have been using healthier stuff and taking care of my skin, that's the reason my makeup lasts so long because I do not need as much coverage as I used to, so my makeup is lasting longer. So if you are in need of a new skin regimen, just let me know and I will share with you mine because my skin has always been horrible. I've had I've been tortured because of my skin. All right, so my blending brush, I'm going to use it for my concealer. All right, so I am going to kind of come in here and kind of start blending like I did. And then I'm going to kind of use my blending brush as a fan brush to get underneath my eye. That's why you just went here, started here, so you can blend it up underneath your eye. And then it gives you a nice soft look as you're seeing it, because I am down here on this brush. If you do not have the blending brush, you need to get it. You need to get the blending brush because it is awesome and it does a lot of things. There are other things that it does, like you can highlight and contour, but this is not a highlight and contouring video because that is a lot of frills. A lot of frills. Do on my nose here. The nose. Make sure you clean it. That's why I said I need two. Just in case it doesn't get cleaned properly, I don't have like makeup on my nose. Eyeshadow on my nose. Go over here. Push that up and make kind of like a fan brush. Kind of. Just dab. I'm just dabbing and swishing. Not smearing. Just dabbing and swishing. That redness that way I can sit here and just make this zit disappear, man. I'm doing a soft brush. Here. All right. Man, my live yesterday, I was rusty. I think I got it now. I'm just gonna talk. I do have a 2-year-old. I don't kind of have a 2-year-old, but I have a 2-year-old who her newest phrase is "I am not." Got the concealer going. I am not is her new thing. I am not. Vera, go do this. I am not. I'm not. It's her new thing. And then if I tell her you don't do this, you're going, you know, she's being really, really bad. You're gonna get spanked. And she goes, I go to corner. So she thinks if she goes to the corner, she'd rather go to the corner than to do what she's told. So I am like, hey. So I'm like, I'm on to these kids. So I make them do what they're supposed to do and act like Everything's going to be okay. I'm not going to put them in the corner. And then guess what happens after they get it done? They go straight to the corner. So you did what I was supposed to, and you went to the corner. That's it. I've been a parent for 7 years, over 7 years, but I'm still learning. And kids are evolving. They're too smart. All right, concealer. I'm just going to do the touch powder. I am going to use a face angled brush, and I'll show you why. So it's a fluffy, but it's angled here. I'm going to show you why I use an angled brush and not just a poofy flat brush on my face. I'll show you that. So this is the Touch mineral powder, pressed powder. And before Ganique, I didn't use pressed powder, and then I love it. I love it. So the reason I use angled brush is to get underneath my eyes. And then get in that little crevice in my nose. So I can get underneath my eyes without putting too much on it and still get on my cheeks. And then I dab. I'm a dabber. You'll notice. I am a dabber. I have found that it blends on my skin better. From all those times that my husband's like, hey, let me blend your makeup in better. I felt like horrible because I'm supposed to be doing makeup for a living, you know? And then I'm horrible. This stuff covers, oh my gosh, I love this stuff. And it doesn't break out my skin. And I really don't have to use a lot. It smells good too. I'm a weirdo. But I do, I clean my brushes with essential oils. So my brushes smell good. It's almost time for me to do that again. Get into those really weird crevices there. Use a lot. So. BMC. All right. Go back to our eyes. And so a lot of you may be scared of liquid eyeliner. I'm going to tell you, you do not need to be scared of liquid eyeliner anymore because this Dip and Draw Precision is awesome. It goes on. I mean, I have to do it sometimes just once, and I love it. Its tip is really, really precise. And then we'll let that dry and then we'll see how long it stays. I took a shower today. So, funny thing about that, I took a shower today. So, you know, with a mom, you know, it's going to be 3 days. So, I'll take another one. So, we'll see how long that heart lasts on there. I told Tyler, I said, before y'all go to Taekwondo tonight, I need to take a shower because I got a live and a class tonight. So, I'm teaching essential oils class after this. So, I'm doing my makeup now and then teaching the class in 30 minutes. So I was like, I have to take a shower. And Lotion looks at me and goes, where are you going? You know, kids think, take a shower, you're going somewhere. It's pretty sad because I don't go very anywhere, really. That was funny. Also, my kids feel that if I go somewhere, they need to go with me and they freak out if I. You see that? That's why I love this stuff. It is simple. Simple, simple, simple. Let's do the other eye. The other eye. Get one eye right, the other eye doesn't want to do right. Or it doesn't want to be the same thickness. My mind playing. right. Let's do our eyebrows and then we'll do our eyelashes. So y'all saw today is when I drew this heart. So y'all are witnesses if I do before and after. How long it stays. I'm not fibbing. Not fibbing. So I have been using the our last serum to help out with my eyebrow lossage when I had alopecia. And I can totally tell the difference because I'm gonna have to cut them because they are growing crazily. I've been doing it for like 3 weeks and they're growing. Now I need to cut them because they're getting a little too tall. A little too tall. I also use it on my hairline too, the last serum, because it's just to make hair, your eyelashes are hair, so it makes it grow and thicken. So I might as well use it on other parts. Why not? Eyebrows. That's what I said I was gonna do. All right, I'm gonna use Brave. I usually use a darker chocolate brown to do my eyebrows. I'm not a big fan of black eyebrows. I don't know what it is. So I come where my eyebrows down there, and I kind of stamp along where it's supposed to come down to. And then I work my way up because these go up and the other ones go sideways. So work on those and fill in these. Trim them. Oh my gosh. I'm not wanting to pluck them too much because I'm kind of working on their thickage. So they're thickening, thickage. We have a brow palette, but this seems to work really well for me. I like things that can double, things that do double duty. And then these go this way, so just swipe this way. And the one thing I did lose was my eyebrows this down here. There's not much hair right here anymore. So your eyebrows, the way they should be, so let me fill in this. Stop talking so I can actually do this. Can talk and do this at the same time. When you're trying to figure out how you should shape your eyebrows, where the arch should start, or where it start here and there. All right. So, your eyebrow, you lay a pencil here by your nose. Your eyebrow should start there. Your arch should stop in the middle of your eye, so your pupil, it should start there. And then take it, put it to the side of you guys, side of your nose, and go this way. And it should end there. Told you I was gonna give y'all tips. So there you go. Give y'all lots of tips. Tips, tips. I'm telling you all my secrets that I learned from other people. I go down here. I'm using the liner brush. Hello, Lizette. I'm using the liner brush to do my eyebrows. So I stamp at the bottom here, trying to give me a reference point where to stop. And then I go up. Like I said, these lashes go up, the other ones go in this way. So there are hairs over here. It's just either they're blonde, which I think they came in blonde. Because when I lost my hair, a lot of my hair came in blonde or gray. So I was lucky that a lot of my hair grew back. I did lose like half thickness of my hair. My hair used to be, you can it in like months because it was so thick. I broke many ponytails in my life. So I probably broke many brushes in my life too. All right, let me show you that trick again. You make sure mine are right. Your eyebrows inside your nose. Your eyebrows should start here. Your arch should start in the middle of your eye, and then put it on the side of your nose. Go upward, and they should end here. So voila. I never thought about doing my eyebrows until I noticed how thin they were getting and how thin they were. And then after doing them a lot, I can't go without them. If I don't wear any makeup, I do mascara. You're gonna do one thing, do lip gloss and mascara. One thing. All right. I need to do my eye serum. This is what I've been using on my hairline and my eyebrows to thicken them up. Really easy to put on. I do it once in the morning and once at night. Hello, Christina. Once at night. Do not be afraid to say hi. I will not bite you. I am behind the screen. I cannot bite you. We're going to just do epic tonight. We're not going to do the whole 3D. A trick, also another trick, several tricks. Do not pump your mascara. Swoosh your mascara or stir it. Pumping it invites bacteria into it. All right, trick doing your mascara is to look down into your mirror and do your mascara. This will help you not get those little mascara lines because this mascara is going to make your eyes really, your eyelashes really long and pop. So look downward when doing them, and you're going to wiggle when you do. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle up. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle up. You can call it shimmy if you want to. You're going to shimmy your mascara. One of these days, I'm going to ask one of y'all to bring you on camera and you do your makeup with me. Wouldn't that be fun? I think it'd be fun. I think my mom should, since she has most of the products. She should. She's got most of them. Wiggle. I think she just needs to buy the presenter's kit and get it done with. Wiggle. Said, look down. You want to have all that mess and freshly done eyeshadow. All right. Epic mask. Yeah. So one night when you're ready, we'll do some makeup together, mother and daughter makeup. I'm not waving at you. I'm making sure they dry. No a problem. My thing of hate is having allergies. You just want to rub your eyes, but you're like, you can't rub your eyes. You just did your makeup. Just did your makeup. So there is the eyeshadow. So it's kind of a brown gold look. The epic and the eyes. So the eyes are done. So let's do the lips. I do not do lip liner. I see no need in doing lip liner. So I'm not going to do it because I feel like that's frills. So I'm not going to do it. But I am going to do a nude, just a nude lip. Like I said, part of the kudos, you get to pick a lipstick. This is well-to-do, which is my favorite. It is a nude color. Nude is in. Nude is in. Lipstick, that is. Especially when you have a more dramatic eye makeup, do nude. If you have a less dramatic eye makeup, if you're going just browns, like a light brown and cream, or anything of that nature, I makeup, mascara. Another tip that gets the makeup off your teeth. I actually learned that on Oprah. And that Oprah, and I've worn the wiggle thing on Oprah a long time ago. Because I haven't watched Oprah since I was a teenager. This is lip floss. It's in Lunar, my favorite color. And I pair it with Well-to-Do because it's nude. Same thing with lip gloss. There we go. Closer to the camera. So between all my talking and everything, that took, a little longer than expected. But I talk a lot. So there it is. There's the look. And those lashes make you just want to blend out your eyes. And the well-to-do lips. You know what? I forgot. I forgot blush. That's okay. Let me do that real quick. So we have Lip Magician blush. And you look at this and you're gonna be like, I was like, oh my gosh, that is just too much. Just too much there. Limited edition. We still have this. You wanna get it? I was like, that is too much. But ladies, it goes on. Through life. I just kind of dip, like barely touch it on there. Just dab in there. Move it on. It's going to last me forever. And I alternate. Besides, when I do my blush, I put it on both sides. I start this. You start here, it's going to give you more blush. So do two over here and then just alternate to blend your So there it is. Now I got to get ready to teach a class, but I will look fabulous doing it. And you may think that we sit here with a nice t-shirt on and nice pants on. We don't. I have my Batman pants on. These are pretty cool pants. It to myself. They have Batman on one leg, and then they can't see her. She's over here. Has Batgirl on the other side. So, I'm sitting here. I think news reporters, I think some states do that as well. They wear pajama pants on the bottom because you can't really see them, and they don't get up. So, they just wear sometimes. I mean, I wonder if sometimes they just don't wear pants at all. I mean, you don't need to. Why? Why do you need to wear pants? All right. I gotta go get ready for a class. But thank you so much for watching. And if you are watching the replay, just do hashtag replay. Y'all give you some love. All right. Remember, always, always, be you, be beautiful, and be beautifully unique.